the French Quarter cops, not like other cops. They are studied throughout the world and renowned as leaders in crowd control because of Mardi Gras. They're really good at this, and they're really large guys. So these giant people on horses, also giant, wearing cop gear, pull up in front of this restaurant. I was like, I've never seen cops this big. And I never saw anything like what happened next. I went up to the first one and I said, hey, my name's Daryl. I was in there. There was a little altercation. That's what I sounded like to myself talking to these guys. There was a little altercation. But I'm going to go home because I don't want any problems. He said this. He goes, exactly like this. He said, there ain't going to be no problem. I was like, what? I said, there ain't going to be no problem. I was like, so the Terminator is a black dude. Yeah. I never saw anyone comfortable with this. Like, that's New Orleans. There's 150 people in there. They've been drinking the good stuff, including the absinthe, all right? They like to cut it loose. They walk in this bar, and they're getting loose like this. You know these leg things that runners do? I can't do it, but I'm doing this thing. They're getting like this, so casual, like, yeah, I swear to God, I'm getting too old for this job. You know, walking in there, getting loose. And everyone shut up. Because when these guys come, you know what happens now. Be quiet. You know, hang loose. Everyone shuts up. Jukebox goes off. And the cop walks up to the table. And he says to these guys, how y'all doing? If termites could talk, they would be making this sound. They went, oh, we aren't eating anything. He said this then. He goes, you know, in the French Quarter, life is all about choices. Sometimes the choices we make, we're determined how we live the rest of our lives. For instance, you could choose to eat your food and mind your business. That's a choice. But that's not the choice you made. You chose to act like a goddamn fool. And then they call us. We come here to change your mind. All right, how do you think we change people's minds? Our particular group. How do we go about that? Persuading people to make a different choice. We don't take them down to McDonald's for a Happy Meal. We put them through a process of alteration. Alteration, right? In normal police jobs, you tune a suspect up. But when you alter somebody, let's just say they might wake up with a speech impediment.